Hi, my name is Brian, and welcome to a video on continuity. In this video, we're going to introduce continuity and the three conditions a function must satisfy in order to be continuous at a point x equals a. So instead of just telling you those three conditions, what I want to do is come up with why those conditions are necessary. So let's start with a really easy example of a function. So something that just looks like this. Now based on this, am I continuous at x equals a? If you use kind of the algebra definition, that would be taking your pencil, putting it on the graph, and tracing it. Now if I ever have to lift up my pencil for any reason, I will not be continuous at that point. I hope you can see as you get near that right there, you're going to have to jump over. In other words, lifting your pencil off the paper. That means we are not continuous at A. So how would we fix that problem? Well, the fix is that f of A must exist. If f of A must exist, that means we're not going to have to jump over this point, and it will be OK. So condition one. All right, so I now tell you that f of A must exist. So here we go. Except now, I'm going to do something like that. Algebra definition of continuity, where I have to lift my pencil up. And if I do, I'm not continuous. Definitely happens here, right? You are going to have to somehow jump up to get to the graph on the other side. Not continuous. So what would the fix be in order to be continuous? Well, the limit from the left-hand side and the limit from the right-hand side have to be the same. Otherwise, you're going to have a jump discontinuity. So let's write that down. The limit as x approaches a of your function has to exist. I'm going to write must exist. So that's condition two that has to be met in order to be continuous. Let's go on to the last one. Again, I'm going to be a little bit annoying. I'm going to satisfy those two conditions, but I'm going to mess something else up. So this, my limit exists, it equals whatever this y value is, but then I'm also going to make f of a exist by then putting a closed dot right there. This graph satisfies those two conditions. So what's left to fix? Well, I need the limit to match the function value. So limit of f of x as x approaches a must actually equal f of a. Now, if you satisfy all three of these conditions, basically meaning that this point is going to go in here, we will be continuous. Now, what about things like vertical asymptotes? Well, vertical asymptotes won't even satisfy the first condition because you're not going to exist at that point, which is why I didn't draw it up as one of the three cases here. Okay, I hope this gives you a little better understanding of what continuity is and what three conditions must be satisfied in order to meet it. Good luck. Bye.